Hi, my name is Ron Stone. This is a bass lesson in Living in a Dream by the Archangels. It's in the key of D. This is a very cool song. It's I don't know if it's hard, but it definitely has a couple of twists in it, which is what I guess what makes it cool. So it's structured into verses, chorus, and solo, and then just outro, which is really a abbreviated repeat of the intro. So I think if you look at it that way, it's easier to organize. There is a lot of repetition, and then there's a couple of opportunities for the bassist to do a couple of licks, and you know, I heard him doing a couple of little trills. I would say that the trills are almost completely optional. I mean, especially in a live performance, you're probably not going to hear a big difference, but if you like them, definitely do them. I'll do the best I can to communicate the ones that I can hear. So the intro is in D on the main D chord, and a lot of it, I play it down here because I can reach all the notes I want to reach easier. I guess you could play it up here, but I like having be able to jump up to the other string. So let me play the first part of it, and then I'll stop and explain further. The intro is sort of what they call a question and answer. There's a statement, and then there's a little lick to follow it. So it's just C to D. And then there's this pull-off thing. So it's just starts on G, the octave of G. Okay, down to the F. And then it's you're pulling off D and C to the A string. And then you just you're on the second fret and you're bending the F sharp up to the G and back to the F sharp. And that's giving you it's basically giving you the third of the D chord that you're on. So you're staying on that one chord is what you're basically doing. So and then you're right back to the D. Okay, and the second time it does it. Which is just, again, you're hitting the octave. Well, I guess over here you're actually hitting the octave of the C chord, but it's just on the 10th and 12th fret, you're on the, you're hammering G to A, and then hitting C. Stuff tabbed out for you so you can hopefully see what I'm doing as well. Okay, so that whole intro phrase is and it's funny because they don't do it every time, but usually right before they start the verse chords, they go, you know, instead of the rest of the time, they're just going, there you go. Okay, so that sort of gets you in time with the drums. I think if you don't do that, you can just hold on the D, I guess, but that puts you in direct time with the drums. Okay, so and then you go into that's the intro, and now you go into the verse. And the first verse does not hit a chorus, so it's just a verse and a stop, which makes it, I guess, easier for learning purposes. We'll be right back. Okay, so the first part of the verse is just C, B, G, and then on the G you're sliding from the F to the G, and I kind of hear it dragging on the slide, suggesting the F sharp in the middle. So it's. And it's C, F, D, back to the root of the song. Okay, so. It does that twice, and then it goes into the second half of the verse, which is coming right up here. Okay, so that's the entire verse structure for the whole song, really. So that last part is that on the second half of the verse. Okay, so it works its way back to a B flat, and the way it does it is it hammers from the C to the D, and then B. So the B is a passing tone to B flat. So. And then it walks back up to the C. And I have that on the tablature. It's B flat, open A, B flat, B, C. And it hits it twice. Okay, and then it lands on the G. Alright? Now it only does that stop in a verse, I think, that first time, because then the next time it's going to lead into the chorus. So the next time it comes up and does it, it stays on the C until it goes into the chorus, which starts on D. Okay? So I'll play through the second verse up till the chorus, which should be pretty much a repeat of what we just played. Just to make quick notes, so that second time around it sort of repeats the intro, but the bass player doesn't do the doesn't do the licks. Now I don't see why. If you don't want it, if you want to ad lib, you can even probably pull off the, but they don't do it on the record. Okay, so anyway, second verse. See, it comes out of the B flat and it stays on the C, and then the chorus is. Okay, so it's all pretty much the same notes, but it just played differently. So you got D, C, B, A, and I hear him doing a little open string between the chords. And then to get back, you can either go. Or there's, if you want to get a little more funky. Okay, just hit that C on the upbeat, but again, optional. Because there's one time where the drummer hits a cymbal at that point. It sounds really cool to hit it with him. I think it's when they do the repeat on the chorus later. But I sometimes just hit it for emphasis. So, D, D, C, C, B, B, G, twice. Okay, so and I'll play that with the record real fast and explain it again. Okay, so that's probably the hardest time thing. The drummer is really your friend in this song, because he really, Chris Layton is the drummer there. He's really the one who's giving you the clues on those awkward parts. So it's twice through. Something either that or something very similar to it coming back to the G after that FC. Again, it's optional. You really don't have to play it. I don't think anybody would say the song, you're playing the song wrong if you don't, but that's what I kind of feel. So that last time through the chorus. And again, the drummer is your friend in there. You're gonna have to listen to that part, and he hits a snare right before you hit. I had to play through it a few times to be able to do it with him, but there is a definite thing that he does that helps you to know when to hit that. And then so I just play around in the G chord, which is I do D C D F D. And there's like a little pause before you hit that lick, so it's that part right there, I had to play through it a few times to cop the feel on it, to cop when I was going to hit it, and again, I want to say, I mean, that shouldn't stop you from playing the song if that particular part is holding you up. I would say you can play it with the band until you get that going. You just, you know, you can just do. You know, because the guitar is going to be doing stuff too. Okay, so that's the first two verses and the chorus. So let's see where we are. Okay, yeah, so it stops after that chorus, and it's going to do the third verse, which is the same as the first verse, except there's instrumental stuff going on with the vocals. And at first you almost think like it might be a solo part or something, but it's not. It's a whole verse. So they're going to do the whole verse through a whole chorus, stop, and then they're going to hit the solo. That's any place with the chords change. So let's go through that third verse. Living in a dream. Okay, I just want to point out real fast, on that third verse, they do something just a little bit weird there when they're doing that intro. They normally, at the end of the first intro, if you remember, it's like, then they do. In that verse, they don't do that last part. They just go. So just keep an eye out for that. Like if you feel like you did something wrong, it's not. They actually just changed it. So that's in the third verse. Now it goes into solo, and the solo moves it up a full step into E, and it's just the solo chords are just over E and A, and then it goes back into the B flat thing, working its way back into the chorus. So it's not really complicated, but what is weird is that he's playing in a very loose sort of time feel over the first E chord, which is double time. So there's basically like four E's and then two A's and then two E's and then the B flat. But it is hard to get on the beat with him because he gets off the downbeat and then he gets back on the beat. So what I do is I just play the octaves of the E through that first part, and then when he gets on the beat in the A, then I'm... part is jumping back on to the A chord with him, and the key is he does a fill, so you're going to want to listen to that fill over and over again until you have that fill memorized and you know when he's coming in. And and if you're still unsure, what you can also do, a little side trick, is just hold on the A until you hear the downbeat hitting and then get back in with him. So I mean, I may have trouble doing it too. I had trouble doing it until I did it a few times myself. So let's see what we got here. So that whole solo sequence again was four E's, two A's, two E's, and then the B flat thing up to the chorus. And the chorus is twice as long. Before you only did the D, C, B, G sequence twice. Now you're doing it four times, but then it stops at the end. And then it's just a quick outro, which they're going over the intro again. And then the song actually ends on the G chord after three times on the D. And that's all that's left, so let's start it up. I'm just living in a dream. Okay, so I hear him doing that two times during that sequence, and then I do it the first and third time, and then the middle one I think is really like player's choice. I mean, I repeated that because I like that lick, but you don't have to. I mean, you can just stay on the D chord or whatever. So that's pretty much the whole song. So like I said, the drummer is definitely a friend in this song, and there's only really two places that I think are anywhere challenging time-wise. One is when it hits the F, and the other one is in the middle of the solo, catching on, getting on the rails on the A chord. But like I said, you know, if you need to cheat, just hold it until your drummer starts hitting the downbeat. Now, your drummer in your band may not even do the weird time. You guys may decide just to keep it regular. You know, and that's fine. You know, I mean, there's sort of a beat there, but Leighton really plays with it, and I couldn't get a definite feel for a pulse, so that's why I just kind of spaced out on the, which is what it sounds to me like Tommy Shannon's doing anyway. So, all right, man, good luck, have fun.